Hold on to your hats, sports fans, this is getting more outrageous by the day. You will be aware, I know, that there is an issue at the moment over whether or not it is a good idea for the state government to go through with its plans to knock over three relatively new stadiums, at Parramatta, Homebush and Moore Park, and rebuild them at a cost of $2.5 billion. The pro-bulldozer mob have on their side all of Alan Jones, the wider SCG Trust, Venues New South Wales, most of News Corp and most importantly the controlling half of the government. The other half think, to use the words of one, it's the dumbest f-king idea I've ever heard. It screams largesse and the public won't buy it. He got that right. For while on the side of sanity, there is no such list of powerful names and institutions, there is one very powerful entity that is extremely engaged. And that is the people of New South Wales. No exaggeration, I have never seen anything remotely like it. The petition I started against it, now has just under 150,000 signatories. The petition started, in response, for the stadium upgrade, which has been widely publicised, has just over 150 signatures. Yes, that's right. Those against it vs those for it, really is about 1,000 to 1. And while I have respectfully asked Premier Gladys Berejiklian three times now, to justify her claim that the $2 billion outlay will be made back in 2 years, as yet there is only radio silence. And the rather unpleasant guffawing of economists who point out that with that kind of a return, private equity would be rushing to finance it, and there would be no need to call on the public purse. And even the government's own figures do them down, as originally revealed by my colleague Jacob Solwick, concerning the insanity of the SFS project alone, which noted the advice of Infrastructure New South Wales that there would be no economic benefit to the state of New South Wales. But still, we have not come to the most stunning development of the last 2 days. For in the middle of all this, which has included Sydney City Council, followed by Radwick and Waverley Council, passing strong motions against the stadium rebuild, we have it on the authority of Channel 9's state political reporter, Chris O'Keefe, that the government is about to make another announcement concerning their sporting largesse, concerning an allocation of $40 million to sport. Who to? Well, specifically, that $40 million is going to NRL clubs, to refurbish their gyms, and expand their facilities. O'Keefe reports that the $40 million is expected to be handed over to 6 clubs. To help clubs build centres of excellence. It is expected South Sydney will be handed money to build at Heffron Park in Maroubra, Canterbury Bulldogs at Belmore, Sydney Roosters at Moore Park, Cronulla at Shark Park and Newcastle Knights at Hunter Stadium. I have no clue why I appear to be close to a lone voice on this, but let me say it loud and proud, regardless. Friends, this is a disgrace. To make a statement of the bleeding bloody obvious. The government has no business handing out taxpayer funds to elite sporting businesses that make their own money already. The NRL itself is a billion-dollar business, at a time when community sport is crying out for resources. And yes, of course the government is dressing up their largesse with the plan that the new centres of excellence will also be open to local communities.